Dear President, members of the Assembly, sponsors of the Solar Transport Program, teachers, participants, and students. We all know that Solar Transport is a fantastic initiative because it teaches us life skills such as public speaking, formal writing, and humor. But that's not even the most significant aspect of it. As a participant of this program, I can assure you that it gives a new perspective on life. It makes you feel grateful for all you have, and it may inspire you to try to change the world moving forward. So I'd like to take a moment and thank everyone who made it possible for me to have this experience. My teachers, assistants, the sponsors of the program, and the Comunidad Andina. But especially my partners in the first grade, Marta, and the nine students who are in New York. I feel incredibly grateful to say that I was chosen as one of last year's spring students who got to go to New York, and I got to live the best trip of my life. One of the things that makes it so special is visiting New York. However, what makes it so unforgettable is the people who are there with you, living the same once in a lifetime of the It is not very often that in a matter of age you become such good friends with my people. Imagine how close it became that by the sixth night we got playing cookies and spent the whole night. Even now, every few months, we still get together and have a great time. Our teachers first told us about global classroom in second grade. And when they explained that we have to do a petition paper and become experts for a country, I think I speak for everyone when I say that we feel incredibly overwhelmed. But I'm sure you already know, you are capable of anything if you take it one step at a time. It takes so much work, patience, and ambition just to get to this point. So I would like to take a moment to congratulate all of you. I really remember being here and listening to another speech a year ago. After it, my friends and I participated in the debate, and I have to say that many thanks to our amazing assistant who passed on to the next round. After that, we had to choose one of us to do the interview, which was a very hard thing to do because we all deserved it just as much. Finally, the interview came, and it was very fun. The best advice I give to anyone who has to do it is to be yourself, because the most important thing to do is to show how much it would mean to you to live the experience of an international day visiting the UN and the rest of New York. I was told that I was going to New York a few weeks after the interview, and it didn't feel real. It wasn't until 2 weeks later that it suddenly happened that I was actually going to go. And at that time, I didn't even realize the fact that it was home. It has been one of the best memories of my life, and I'm sure I'll never forget. I know it doesn't seem probable to be one of the 10 people who get to vote, but remember that every single person who has won has been in your positions right now, and everyone here has the exact same chance of voting. So look around you, because in a few months, 10 of you are going to be at the airport remembering this moment, and in a year, one of you will be. And if you are lucky enough to be one of them, remember that everyone here is entitled to go as you are. And no one can take away the amazing experience that these debates have brought. Don't worry if you think that other delegations have not been here, or if you haven't spoken as much as you would have. Because everyone has that time. Don't lose hope if you are given an award after the debate, because most of the people who went to New York, including me, didn't get one. Just do your best and take your own, because it's the best way to take advantage.